I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal, before this decade is out, of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the earth.
In the 1960s, an impossible dream came true, when human beings walked on another world.
The Eagle has landed.
In all, 24 Americans went to the moon. But it took an unseen army of over 400,000 engineers and technicians to make it possible.
Altitude 1600.
Eagle looking great. Roger, 1202, we copy it.
35 degrees, 750, coming down to 23. 540 feet, down to 15. 1050 feet, down at 4. Altitude velocity light, picking up some dust. Fake shadow. 4 forward, drifting to the right a little.
30 seconds.
Forward, just. Contact light. Okay, engine stop.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
During the initial climb out at 180 knots, the crew checked out the flight controls and evaluated the aircraft's handling characteristics, while the pilot kept up radio chatter with flight controller via the Blue Ridge station. At 10,000 feet above Catalina Island, the aircraft was leveled off and entered a holding pattern, maintaining a speed of 200 knots. The landing gear flap and slat actuations were observed and evaluated. Then the pilot headed the aircraft towards Edwards Air Force Base, 75 air miles north of Long Beach Airport. Climbing to 20,000 feet, the DC-10 leveled off and kept its cruising speed at 300 knots as planned. Flight control evaluation was conducted, and engine operating characteristics were observed. Subsequently, the DC-10 was climbed to 30,000 feet. There it began phase two of its flight development. Additional weeks of strenuous testing. On the 24th of October, DC-10 number 3 made its first flight, the second DC-10 to enter the flight development program. On this first flight, DC-10 number 3 flew to Yuma and landed, then returned to Long Beach Airport the same day. But the DC-10 has already won the hearts of the crew since its memorable first flight. They have judged it the most airworthy, responsive, efficient, and economical DC airplane yet.
Let's go for today's launch of Space Shuttle Discovery.
NTD, this is SRO on 212.
Right, SRO.
go ahead.
Cicero.
You go.
Brain status is no-go at confident in the system as long as they didn't select that screen that we were confident in the system. However, the same event was experienced when selecting a different screen. They are not confident in the system at this time, and brain status is no-go.
Okay, what's your estimated time to repair?
We do not know right now. They're having a nominal discussion, but right now we only have a couple of minutes to be able to give you our poll. And we're thinking at this time we're not going to be able to support C0.
Okay, keep us informed.
I will.
Entity launch director, let's calm down. They're working a little issue over there. We'll give them a few minutes to work it. If they get green, we'll be in good shape. And in order to support that entity, I'd like you to do your poll on time. And I will as well, and we'll be ready to go when range clears up.
Copy that. We'll be ready.
Thank you.
This is shuttle launch control. 5 minutes remaining in our hold at T-minus 9 minutes.
This is the NTD conducting the launch status check. All stations verify ready to resume count and go for launch. OTC? OTC go. TVC?
TVC go.
PTC?
PTC's go.
LPS?
LPS is go.
Houston Flight.
Houston Flight is go.
Mila.
Mila's go.
STM.
STM is go.
Safety console.
Safety console's go.
STE.
STE is go.
LRD.
LRD is go.
SRO.
SRO is no go.
Copy. Are you good to go to 5 minutes and hold?
Yes, we are good to go 5 minutes and hold.
Copy. And CDR.
Discovery is go.
Launch director NTD.
Yes, sir.
Okay, our launch team is ready to proceed. SRO has a concurrence to go to 5 minutes.
Okay, copy all that. I'll do my poll this time. KC, Chief Processing Engineer, verify no constraints to launch.
No constraints.
Thank you, Steve. KC, Safety and Mission Assurance.
KC, Safety and Mission Assurance is go pending resolution of the range issue.
Copy. Payload Launch Manager.
Flight is to go.
Copy. Range weather.
Weather has no constraints for launch.
Copy. Thank you, Kathy. And Ops Manager.
Ops team, Mike, on our side, MMT's in really good shape. Vehicle's looking perfect. Weather's looking great. We'll stand by here and see if the range can resolve their issue, but we are go.
Okay, copy that, and we'll take it on down to 5 and see if we can't get there.
Yeah, it's a good plan, Mike. Let's keep going.
And KC Safety and Mission Assurance?
KC Safety and Mission Assurance.
Let's see, if we get the go from SRO, you're going to be go. Is that a firm? We don't
that
have to re-poll you.
Mike. Yes, we are go.
Right, so we will not re-poll you if we get a go from SRO.
That's affirmative.
Thank you, sir.
Concur.
Just a few seconds away from resuming their countdown.
Countdown clock will resume on my mark.
NTD safety.
3, standby safety. 2, 1, mark. T-minus 9 minutes and counting. TLS auto sequence has been initiated.
And the ground launch sequencer has been initiated. All countdown functions now automatically controlled by the GLS computer located in the firing room integration console. Energy wave.
GLS is go for main engine.
Go for main engine start. Start. 2, 1. Booster ignition and the final liftoff of Discovery. A tribute to the dedication, hard work, and pride of America's space shuttle team. The shuttle has cleared the tower.
Discovery now making one last reach for the stars. Through the area of maximum pressure, reducing the stress on the shuttle as it goes supersonic.
Discovery Houston, you are go at throttle up.
Separation confirmed.
Will Commander Steve Lindsay acknowledging the call from Capcom Charlie Hoba as Discovery's three main engines throttle back up.
Traveling at a rate of 370 miles per hour. landing gear now down and locked. Main gear touchdown. Pilot Jim Dutton now deploying the drag chute.
Separated from the rocket, the X-43 accelerated on its own power to Mach 7.
Mach 7 is approximately 5,000 miles per hour, so you can imagine flying New York to Los Angeles in just over a half an hour.
The NASA Dryden Flight Research Center says the scramjet-powered X-43 is capable of reaching at least Mach 10. A scramjet is a supersonic combustion ramjet. The ramjet, sometimes called the flying stovepipe, is one of the simplest engine designs ever conceived, with virtually no moving parts. It's basically a hollow tube into which fuel is injected and ignited. Unlike regular jets, there are no compressor blades inside to compress the air. In a ramjet, supersonic air is slowed down to subsonic speed inside the jet engine. But in a scramjet, the air moves through the engine at supersonic speed.
The X-43 vehicle has to endure some very extreme temperatures. The temperature along the leading edges of the vehicle, for example, are in excess of 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit.
The front of the X-43 and the leading edges of the tail are made of carbon-carbon, a lightweight and strong composite material that can withstand extremely high temperatures.
Carbon-carbon that we use is sort of a high-tech cousin to carbon fiber. The carbon itself is different. It's a much higher temperature. The bonding agent is much higher temperature. It's good to 3,000 degrees without degrading. It doesn't wear away.
What you see is the front end of the vehicle, the tungsten nose. The very front edge is the carbon-carbon leading edge that provides the thermal protection. As you can see, there's a lot of complicated machinery and very densely packed systems inside this vehicle in order to make it work.
A number of small electric motors on the aircraft are controlled by computer signals from the ground.
Motors on these electric actuators move the surfaces. That's how we maintain control of the vehicle in flight.
Ignition.
Keeping the fuel burning inside the engine at supersonic speeds has been described as trying to keep a match lit in a hurricane.
Tango 02, the readback is correct. Turn left now, heading up 090. Maintain 4,000, please.
Dodger Stadium, 10 o'clock.
Sorry. There's Dodger Stadium right under him. You're getting a great shot. There's Dodger Stadium.
Yep.
Boom. Right underneath. Oh, look at that.
Right 20 after.
Good time.
Zero approach 24 right. Astro 9 heavy in flight. Los Angeles.
Good to be here.
Okay. We'll let him go forward a little bit on us.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.